Good morning.
Good morning.
This is a good day. The day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. God is on our side. We must trust. I think they're passing out. Pray, I think I have enough. Little information. I just follow the Holy Spirit. Sometimes we want to change and do things our way. And God says no. So you have to go back, do what He tells you to do. You know, with this lesson, the value of being an aged Christian woman, I had to put down mature as well. Because there are a lot of us that, not old, in age, but mature in the faith. So I have to go back a little bit and bring us up from where our foreparents came and how we arrived as being senior citizens, young adults, and young women. And I love the old song. And I'm looking around and I think I see a few that might know. So gotta help me to sing it. I love the glory. Mama never used to say, long as I live, and will thrive. Yes, sir. They moaned us to this point. Being an aged Christian woman.
Yeah.
Mentor. Titus 2, 3 through 5, and Ephesians 5, 22. 2 Corinthians 4 and 7, 8, the Bible tells us that we have this treasure in earthly vessels. We are a gem. That the excellency of the powers may be of God and not of us. We've been cut. We've been polished, aged women, valuable stone. Do we really appreciate the importance of being an aged Christian woman?
Yeah.
God's presence dwells within us. So we must teach in the word by example daily. We must teach in the word of God and by examples. Yeah, we are a valuable asset.
Yeah.
God has left us here on this earth for such a time as this. There's a war. And it's just as physical as it was in yesterday. It is today. The general theme for this 13th annual women conference. I just have some questions. They're rhetorical, so you know. Are we committed, confident, and courageous in doing the work of ministry as women of God? Are we doing anything to help someone on this earth?
Yeah.
Are we assured beyond doubt that God is able to complete his work in us and others? Are we just saints? Are we bold in the ministry God has assigned us? Or do we say someone else will do it? You know how we are. Do all the time that somebody else. But God has instructed us and given us a command as mature Christian women to pass on the good news and things we have learned in our lifetime to help the next generation.
Yeah.
So they are prepared to help somebody else. We are God's workmanship.
Yeah.
Prepared to serve him in this capacity of service. Ephesians 2 and 10 tells us that. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we walk in them. His creation, which let us know we had no part in doing. God has morally recreated us by Christ Jesus for good works. Jesus remade our spiritual life so we could do work. And we can do good work. Teach. Not in word only, but in example. And we do it by daily living in God's life. We are a valuable asset for such a time as this. But that's just a good example for us.
Yeah.
I like the Old Testament because it's examples in there for us to follow. And if we would look back on them sometime, maybe we would have so many such times. We live long enough. So we can teach. Regardless of your age, if you have learned anything about the word of God and life, you have been commanded to teach. Don't follow what some of us say. They don't listen. Well, we know that. But the word tells us, tell them anyway. Just like our mothers and our aunties and all the old ladies in the community. You walk by them and you don't speak, they stop. You got your blouse buttoned down too low, they put you back on. If your skirt too short, they just pull it down. And they didn't care whether you liked it or not.
That's it. That's it.
Oh, Jesus.
But they loved us. And they taught us how to live properly.
Right.
As a young woman. Have to put your body in old exposition. Yeah.
Ah.
Your yeah. body is a temple of God. That is for one man. It's for him.
Yeah.
That came from. Right mind, because I am teaching. I learned from the littlest to the oldest. Because the little ones can remind you sometimes. But they tell the truth. And I tell them to continue doing it. I got my whole family in trouble. They didn't let me know nothing. So if mama asked me or dad asked, I was going to tell them exactly what happened. So they was in trouble. My oldest sister, I told you, the Baptist. She's supposed to babysit. She called me around into the back door and gave me an apple out of the lady's house. I said, you sit right on this step. And you don't go around on the front. My children, they're mine. So I got up, start walking around the front of the and eat mine. The mother said, where you get that from? I said, that came to me. Well, you know, I was in trouble with her next time she stayed at home with me. But it's just good, like I tell my grandchildren.
That's right.
You don't have to remember.
Right, right, right.
A lie you can't catch up with. Because it's gone. You don't know what you say. You got to make up something. So you tell the truth. Keep your eyes up. But you can't repeat it. Keep sound doctrine. There are some things that we need to do. See, women. Two of women in the Word. I know some of you are under 5, 6. But if you mature in the Word of God, the younger one. Words. And what you have experienced, you can do that. Because God has already prepared you. Like I told you, you are a gem. You live 50 years somewhere along the line. You've been cut up, polished, you've been thrown in the fire. Like the Lord bring you out as soon as you get too hot. Too long. Just like every bird cut. You have a strong one, and then they go for a seed like a half a second, and then they're right back. Hey, we had it. We need to separate ourselves from the world way of thinking and living. Because the world way is shallow, careless, and anything you know. Bad is good, wrong is right. We as the more mature Christian women teach by word and example. I can't put too much emphasis on that. How to conduct oneself as a Christian woman. We need to be free from judgment. Because the Bible teaches us, judge not, lest ye be judged. Not saying that we should never exercise judgment of any kind under any circumstance, but we cannot judge the inner motive of others because only God knows the heart.
Yeah.
If we remind ourselves what Paul penned in 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, 9 through the 10th verse. 1 Corinthians, 6th chapter. When I read this, I said, my God. But Paul said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Tells us to be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor adulterers, nor impotent, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, that's homosexuality, nor thieves, nor covetous, that's those that want everything that they see that belongs to somebody else, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. And then he said, and search for some of you. Now that's a little powerful for you. Let's go back over here tonight. And see what in the third chapter, I think I read it in the third chapter, the fifth verse. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lust and pleasure. What was that sister Esther said last night? Went somewhere and come back. Living in malice and envy, we all do. Hateful and hating one another. But then he encourages us. He said, but after that, the kindness and love of God, our Savior, towards man appeared. He loves us. We were sometimes foolish. Might not have done everything that 1 Corinthians 6, 9, and 10 said, but let's stay in our lane. Because when we talk about, look down on our younger women, judge them about their conduct. Just remember, like I said, 11:8 says, and such were some of us, might not have done what verse 9 and 10 says, but we did something that did not please God.
Right.
Whatever it was or is, that's just the case still in some of it falls under the head of disobedience to God. That's how we got in trouble. Are we being sober, sensible? Are we being dignified, thoughtful? And how sound is our faith? Do we show love? Do we have patience with others? How is our behavior? Are you a false accuser? You drink wine? Some of you said, use the scripture, it's a good first thing. But you pass drinking a little glass of wine. You not drunk. Wine is good because it kills them all that little bacteria. It's wrong. Are we teaching good things? Or are we doing it my way? Paul tells us to prepare ourselves. So when God opens the door for us to encourage a young convert, a younger woman, we do it so the word of God will not be blasphemed. Or accepted for something that we cause the word to be blessed. Now teachers of good things. We have been instructed by elders. the Almighty God. El Elyon, the Most High God. Oh, glory, Sister West. I always think about that song, the Most High God. Elohim, the one that said, let us make man in our image. I'm talking about him. The one that's all knowing and all powerful everywhere at the same time. The one that has nothing to learn, nothing to acquire, nothing to become. He got more education than all of us put together. He knows us intimately. You can find that in Psalms 139, 1 through 6, where such knowledge is a cause for alarm for the unrighteous. But for us, the righteous, confident for God. For us, we are somebody in Christ. We have been chosen. Not here, but this world. It has been taught from generation to generation. Now is our time to tell it all. Let's not be the reason for the next generation not knowing the truth. When we stand before God, all of us want to hear, well done, thy good and faithful servant. So teach the word of God. Teach it daily, your walk, your talk. 2 Corinthians 13 and 5. It tells us to examine yourself. Whether ye be in the faith, prove your own self. That's what we're talking about. Know ye not that your own self, how that Jesus is in you, except ye be reprobate? Are you a faith, a counterfeit? I call it a great pretender. I don't stand for the test. Test yourself. Question yourself. What am I doing? What am I saying? My Lord, are we being the woman and the man, woman of God that we should be? Lord have mercy. Help me, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Matt. Not saying, praise God, here we go. We are not following the word of God. If we are not following the word of God, how can we teach?
Right.
You are in a corner. On the corner. It's called the card line. And the three-way get three more ways.
Yep.
And the three-way get three, and the pretty soon got about 16, 18. That's right. Talking about others. You teaching good things? No. You acting like the world? How can you teach? You a busybody, always in other people's business. How can you teach? It's wrong. It's just wrong. But at the market, you need to tab on. Or watch all these reality shows.
Yeah.
And you teach against the foolishness of the world. Are you involved in it yourself? This body. You know, we have to learn things that grow. Yes. somewhere in the Word of God. They just simplify it. Right hand, that work, devil workshop. You need to get busy. Go get that quilt, go down, teach you how to make some. Go get some patches. Teach you how to make quilt.
Yeah.
Keep the hands busy. The mouth shut. Mind your own business. Learn how to take care of your own house. Love your own children. Love your own husband.
Yeah.
Don't be out there hiding. Paul says that he rather the younger women or the younger widows manage their homes. Because if you're not doing anything, if you're not married, God got something for you.
Yeah.
And it's work for him.
Right.
And if you want a husband, you are a young woman that don't have one, you pray and ask God for one. Then you get busy doing God's business while he's preparing you for the man and the man for you. Because see, you've been single a long time. You're setting your way.
Sure is.
I ain't cleaning. I'm not cleaning. And if you put the toilet paper on the wrong way, I want a divorce. Come home from what? You single. So wherever you take your shoes off is where you leave.
That's right.
So you go to do actually 7 days a week. It's 7 pounds on you. I'll hang up there on the weekend. But I'm going to tell you, young women. I was married 52 years. You make that man feel like that's his captain. When he comes home, he can sit in his favorite chair. Get comfortable. Don't get upset if you have to cook his dinner and fix his plate and sit it on the table. It's okay.
Yeah, that's okay.
You bring that check home.
Amen.
He's not feeding you.
Amen.
Physical or verbal.
Right.
You are his queen.
That's it.
Stand and take your position.
Yeah.
And be that woman.
Right, right.
He loves to come home to.
Yeah.
And then you can talk to anybody. Because he comes home.